So I just finished a haircut on my sister. We're gonna go ahead with the blow dry now, and I just wanted to explain a little bit how I prefer to blow dry my clients. I like to start with really wet hair. If you take the blow dryer to someone's hair that's already dry, mainly at the scalp, you're not able to manipulate the hair the way you need to. So it's best to have it very wet, not dripping, but towel dried and wet. I'm gonna go ahead and add just a heat protectant and a little bit of an oil on her ends to add some shine. Actually, I'm gonna skip the oil, and if we need to, we can add that at the end. For now, we'll just get the heat protectant on there. Okay, now I'm gonna go ahead and take the blow dryer to it. You wanna get the hair about 80% dry using your hands before you take any kind of brush to the hair. If you take the brush to sopping wet, now there are exceptions to this, to get somebody's hair very, very straight, you want the hair to be a little more wet when you take the brush to it so that you can kind of get that tension. I like to go in with my hands for Aaliyah's hair, get it about 80% dry, and then really take the brush to it after that. Anytime taking the brush to it before then, you're really just spending extra time that you don't need to spend. The brush is gonna do what it needs to do, even with the hair about 80% dry. So yeah, let's go ahead and get it blow dried. We'll use the brush towards the end, and then I am gonna section and add some loose waves to her hair. Also, I do wanna mention, when blow drying, don't be afraid to really get your fingers in there. Make sure you can feel the scalp and lift the hair off of the scalp with tension to direct the hair where you want it to go. If you see somebody has a strong cowlick that's shifted their hair to the left, then get your hands in there. Don't be afraid to get in there. Lift it up and rotate it the opposite direction of where you want it to really get that volume at the scalp. And this is also going to prevent the hair from getting oily quick. Once the hair's lifted off the scalp, it's not laying tight to it so the oil is absorbing in your hair. You're gonna get a longer lasting blowout by getting it up off of the scalp and creating that volume. Okay, now I've got her hair about 80% dry. Because her hair is so thick, I am going to section it and blow dry in sections. This will just help me keep everything a little more organized. Some clients, I can just push their hair to one side and start working with the brush. But because she has a lot of hair, we are gonna section. Also, I do want to mention the tip of this blow dryer. This is called a concentrator. I know a lot of people who are not in the hair world, they get this with their blow dryer and they just chuck it in the trash or throw it in a drawer and never use it. This is called a concentrator because it concentrates the air. Imagine the air coming out colored. You would see it would be in a nice tight stream until it went out further. And that way you can really concentrate the air down the hair shaft to help seal the cuticle of your hair, add shine, add smoothness. It really is a big, big benefit to blow drying. So hang on to your concentrators and utilize them. we got her hair looking very smooth just with a brush and a blow dryer. So now I'm gonna section it again and we're just gonna pop a few curls in it. A nice beachy wave look, nothing too complicated, just something easy. we're done with the curls, just some loose waves. I'm gonna comb through a little bit, and then we'll tousle with just a little bit of a texture spray for some hold and a little grip. That is a gorgeous little blowout. Earlia. Nice and easy. She's got great thick hair, so it should hold all day, maybe even a couple. Okay. Thanks for watching.